Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, we'll run through the interoperability between Flame and Baselight. So through the use of Flame's Pybox architecture and the FilmLight BLG plugin, you're able to load the grade information from Baselight directly into any edits and composites in Flame. So regardless of their complexity, you can load Baselight grades into Flame, see everything in the context of the grade without rendering, and even process the final results within Flame using the BLG plugin. So only metadata is passed between the applications, allowing you to work faster without constantly rendering. This workflow is currently only available for Flame on Linux, as the BLG plugin is not currently available on Mac OS X. Now the big question in all of this is, where do you start? Well, the great answer is that it doesn't really matter. You can start by grading in Baselight first and then go to Flame. Or you could start in Flame, then perform grading in Baselight and have that update in Flame. The workflow is completely open to fit in any production pipeline. So let's start off with a conform in Flame, and this sequence was assembled via an EDL using various media sources. This material is tagged as ArriLogC, and it's currently being viewed through the ArriLogC viewing transform. You can work in any color space you want, but I'm highlighting this as we want to keep everything consistent between the applications. Now at any point, you could begin your VFX and finishing work irrespective of what may be happening in the Baselight grading session. Switching over to Baselight, the same EDL has also been conformed using the same media. I'd like to point out that even though it would be ideal to have all the media centrally located on a SAN or NAS, this is not a compulsory requirement, as the BLG grades use metadata like source timecode, etc. within the file rather than the file location. So in this conform, the shots have already been graded, and there is a mix of base grades, secondaries, shapes, and tracking. In order to hand the Baselight grades over to Flame, you need to export a set of BLG files. Click the View menu and choose to display the shots window. If you have made any editorial adjustments, you could click on the cog icon and export an EDL. But right beneath that, choose to export BLGs. Firstly, you would define a directory to save the BLGs. In this case, this is our first grade version, so this will go in a directory called grade 1. Next, you choose to either export the BLG for the current shot or all the shots in the timeline. The single BLG is handy if you just want one grade. Or if you're updating a grade in a single shot, you don't need to export the entire timeline. Since we have a whole edit to effect, choose all the shots. Ensure the scale is set to full, and the frame setting is set to first frame. Since the BLGs will be read by the BLG plugin, all the metadata is supported. So enable the various options and click the export button. Now for your extra information, once this is complete, if we navigate to the BLG folder, you will find a set of EXRs that contain the BLG grades, as well as a split screen preview of the before and after with the grade. Flame will extract the metadata from these files using the BLG plugin and apply the grades to the clips in Flame. Now let's switch back to Flame on Linux and see the various ways in which you can load the Baselight grades onto the shots. The BLG files can be exported in their original exported location, or you can copy them to another location which is accessible to Flame. Starting at the very beginning, you can load a Baselight grade onto a single shot. For example, you would select your segment and call up the effects ribbon with Control Tab. In the pop-up window, you would choose Pybox. Pybox is a Python handler in Flame, which allows Flame to access other applications and plugins and have their data accessible within the Flame pipeline. With the FilmLight BLG plugin installed, you would choose the BLG script, and this will allow you to load BLG grades directly onto the segments. All you need to do is click the Select BLG folder and navigate to the location of the exported BLG files. You define this folder as the directory, and looking at the viewport, the Baselight grade is applied to the shot. With the grades option set to BLG files, the BLG plugin scanned the entire directory and it used the metadata within the BLG files to match up the shot with the correct grade. If you were to go to the next shot and copy the Pybox timeline effects to the segment, the grade will be different because it's reading the metadata of the segment as well as the metadata in the BLG file to assign the correct grade. If you go into the Pybox timeline effects, you can even enable the metadata display to see all the information that Baselight brings in with the BLG metadata. So you can have this information on or off. This is totally frame accurate. To illustrate this point further, if we go back to the first shot, I want to point out that in Baselight, a shape was tracked over her face and the layer was graded. If you were to select the segment and apply a speed change using a time warp timeline effects, when I switch to duration mode and set the duration to 30 frames, which is twice as fast, as I scrub the segment, the shape is still perfectly locked onto the image. The BLG plugin knows what frames are being displayed with the speed change and adjusts the grade data to match. Now, as an extra option, if you just wanted to load a grade on a shot regardless of the metadata, such as a generic type of grade, you could switch the Pybox options from BLG files to 1BLG. You would just choose a BLG file, and whatever grade it contained will be applied to the shot. Not something that would probably be used often, but the choice is there. Now we'll discuss updating BLG grades very shortly, but I do want to highlight that adding 1BLG file at a time to a shot is not very editorial friendly. So I'll undo and remove everything that has been done so far to this sequence. To apply the BLG grades to the timeline in one quick operation, you can add another video track to your edit and select the virtual gap clip on video track 2. As before, call up the effects ribbon and apply a Pybox timeline effects. Choose the BLG script again. If you're not seeing your grade, click the button and choose the relevant directory containing the BLG files. You can either start scrubbing the sequence or check for updated BLGs. As we look through the sequence and toggle between the video tracks, you can see the different grades have been applied to each shot. So the gap segment is scanning the segments on the track below and applying the right grades to each shot. Even if you were to make editorial changes, the grade will follow the segment. So this is a very powerful workflow using the BLG plugin through Pybox. Now let's say that possibly the grade needs to be changed, either in the middle or even end of the job. This can be done without too much concern. For example, let's switch back to Baselight and make a change on a shot. I'll use the first shot again with the shape track. I'll just brighten the face some more and make it quite red. So the grade is now different to Flame. Go to the Views menu and call up the Shots window. Choose to export the BLGs again. Since this is only a single shot, choose to export on the current shot. I'm going to overwrite the original grade since this is only one shot. If you wanted to version your BLG grades, you could create a new folder and export all the BLG files there. So we'll export only the current shot and take a look at how that updates in Flame. Looking at the Flame timeline, the first shot still has the original grade applied to it. Click Check for updated BLGs now. The BLG plugin rescans all the BLG files and updates the grade in the shot. Obviously, I overwrote the original BLG file. If you wanted to keep the original grade for versioning, you would export the new BLGs to a new directory and point the BLG plugin to the new location. So that's how you apply Baselight grades in the context of the Flame timeline. It's pretty much renderless, and only metadata is being passed back and forth. Finally, the last part that will be covered in this video is how to work with the BLG files when working in the batch flow graph. So I'll switch to batch, and here is a shot from the sequence that needs a bit of paint work. Now you have the ability to work before the grade or after the grade. For example, we'll drag out a Pybox node from the batch node bin and attach it to our source clip. We'll choose the BLG script once more and point the BLG plugin to the location of the BLG files. Now looking at the result, the BLG plugin will still not find the right grade for this media. The reason for this is that the source timecode is not fed through the batch flow graph. So go back to batch and select the Pybox node. In order to get it to work, you need to copy the metadata from the source clip into the Pybox node. To do this, with the Pybox node selected, hold T and click on the source clip. This is a very important step and you must not forget it. Returning back to the Pybox node, there is the grade with the tracked shape. To paint out the tracking markers after the grade, go to the batch schematic and connect the paint node after the Pybox node. In the paint controls, I'll set the brushes to paint on all frames, and I'll use the cloning brush. I'll define the offset using Control Click and proceed to paint out all the markers. So that's doing a form of VFX work on top of the graded result. Admittedly, it might be quite tricky because all the shading in the grading makes the paint work a little more challenging. So instead, let's do the cleanup work before the grade. Go back to the batch schematic and move the paint node before the Pybox node containing the BLG grade. When you look at the result of the paint node, the background green is more even and the paint strokes I did earlier clean up the image more accurately. Now if you go back to the schematic and look at the Pybox node, here is the cleaned up plate with the grade, and it looks much better in this case. So everything is always live in the node flow graph, and the grade is considered as an effect, rather than importing new media and replacing everything. If a new grade happens to come your way, you simply refresh the Pybox node and the new Baselight grade will take effect. It's very useful to be able to see the approved grade as a context while you work, and you can decide whether or not to bake it in as part of the composite. Finally, it is important to mention with this workflow that the input and output color spaces are not locked. In other words, the colorist may have done the grade while viewing it as Rec 709. However, you can still output the work in Log C or Scene Linear Working Space if that is your requirement. Don't forget about the T-click tip to ensure the BLG files loaded correctly in the Pybox node, and enjoy using your Baselight grades as part of your flame finishing experience. Remember to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2019.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.